All right, so for the shapes of distribution, there's three key characteristics. One is the skew of a distribution. This is how symmetrical or asymmetrical a distribution is. There is kurtosis. That's how squished or flat or piled up a distribution is. And then there's modality, which is how many peaks a distribution has. And so I'll go through each of these separately in more detail. All right, another important feature of the shapes of distribution is skew. So skew is when a tail of a distribution is pulled away from the center. It's also the case, it's always also the case that it is an asymmetrical distribution. So skew refers when there's an asymmetrical distribution. You can think about that being when the tails are pulled out. So if we draw a normal distribution, right, say it's a IQ, that'd be a normal distribution. It's supposed to be in the middle there, right in the mean. So you could have a skewed distribution that looked like that, or you could have a different one that looked like that. So those are the two kinds of skewed distributions. And we'll talk about this one for a second. So this one, when it's skewed with the tail being pulled off this way, that is left skewed, also known as negatively skewed. And if it's pulled off to the right, that is right skew, also known as positive skew. And it's kind of the one way to remember the positive versus negative, because it's actually more common in language, is if there were a zero at the mean, right, this one, like the tail is extra out in the negative values, right, and if there was a mean of zero here, the tail is out in the positive values. So one reason, if you're collecting data, that you might end up with a left skewed data set is you could have a ceiling effect. So for example, if these are exam scores and these are percents, and 100% is here, that is a ceiling, an upper cap on how high scores can go. Right, and we'll say that this is down at like 50 and zero. So just a few folks got 0 points on this. But when there's a ceiling effect, when there's an artificial cap, what often ends up happening is the scores get squished up against that cap because they can't go any higher. You end up with a left skewed distribution. On the other hand, and this is common in nature, you get right skewed distributions when there's something called a floor effect. It's like there's a floor effect or a ceiling effect, like in a room. A floor effect happens when there's a limit on the bottom. So let's say we are doing counts of the number of deer in national parks or something like that. So this is zero, this is 1,000, and this is 2,000. Well, you can't have negative values for the number of deers in the park because it's a ratio scale variable. So what you'll end up is you'll end up with a lot of parks whose count is pushing up against the bottom number. And that's true for a lot of different ratio variables. Well, there'll be this floor effect, and you'll end up with a positive skew. All right, so skew is another one of these important characteristics of distributions. All right, so a whole other important feature of the shapes of distribution is called kurtosis. It's a very strange word, right? And this refers to how flat or peaked, squished together, a distribution is. So kurtosis has three different kinds, and I'm going to start with the middle kind, which is called mesokurtic. And distributions that are mesokurtic are just as spread out as a normal distribution. And so this is the kurtosis that's in the middle, just like Mesoamerica is the part of between North America and South America. Mesoamerica is in the middle, just like mesokurtic is in the middle for the degree to which these are spread out. So I could draw it like this, right? And so this would be a normal distribution. Distributions that are flatter than normal are called platykurtic. So this is for distributions that are flatter than normal. So if I draw one, it looks maybe something like that. I'm trying to make it more squished down, almost like you put your hand on the top and squished it. That's what I'm looking for there. And this is actually pretty easy to remember too, because in Australia, there's this little animal that looks exactly like this called a platypus. And it's a platypus because it's got a flat bill. Platy means flat, right? So this is the kind of kurtosis that's flat like a platypus's bill. Then the last kind of kurtosis, it's called leptokurtic. And this is distributions that are more squished in than a normal distribution. Distribution. So it might look something like that. So it's almost like you took a normal distribution and squished it in, it got taller. That's a leptokurtic distribution. And the only advice I have for remembering that is it's not platykurtic, it's not mesokurtic, so it's not the flatter one, it's not the middle one, it's the other one, and that's the skinny one. Notice these can be symmetrical. So skew and kurtosis are pretty much unrelated to each other. So another important feature of the shapes of distribution is the distribution's modality. And that refers to the number of peaks that a distribution has. So a unimodal distribution has one peak. A bimodal distribution has two peaks. So I could maybe draw an example. So the normal distribution is unimodal. Bimodal might look something like that. And then usually you don't say trimodal after this. You usually just say multimodal. And that refers to a distribution that has three or more peaks. All right, so I don't know, you don't really come across these much. But that would be a multimodal distribution. So right, so uni just means one peak or mode. Bi means two modes. Multi means more than one mode. So that's modality.